So this is my typical setup for live streaming and even podcast recording at my desk, my computer. It's my Rode PodMic attached to the Rode PSA One boom arm. Probably one of the best boom arms I think you can get. But I want to see how it compares to the Elgato arm and if I can go more
low profile.
Once I take all this off, I'll pop it on the Elgato boom arm and I'll tell you what I like and don't like. So here it is hooked up. This is the Elgato Wave Mic Arm LP, and the LP stands for
low profile.
There's some things I like about it and some things I don't like about it. So here's one thing is right now it's lower in the frame as opposed to like having the mic up here, which I'll show you the difference here in just a second. So that's nice. I was a little worried that as I'm on my keyboard and my mouse that the arm would be too low. It's not. So that's cool. And I can slide it underneath my monitor. So I have a 34-inch widescreen, and what I can do with that monitor is I can raise it up and down. I was a little worried that the arm would not be able to tuck under. It does, but I have to raise the monitor up a little. You know, it feels very sturdy. It can turn.
Uh-huh.
So I can swing it in and out. I do like that it's easy to set up, just like the Rode PSA One mic arm, which is this one. It's easy to set up. You literally have the base that you screw to a desk. There's not like a separate system where you can drill through. I didn't see one in the box. I don't ever drill through my desk. So it's easy just to clamp to the desk, and it's got a very wide base, so you can do that. And then you pop the arm in, and that's it. Price-wise, compared to the Rode PSA 1, this is around, I think it was around maybe a little under $150, where the Rode is right at $99. One thing I've always liked about the Rode PSA 1 arm is wherever I put it, it stays. This seems to do the same. Now, here's some things I don't like about it and didn't like about it, and the reason that I may not keep it. One, these things right here, they're intended to hide the cable and they just pop off like crazy. And I saw some reviews where guys were saying, yeah, if the cable moved much, it popped them off. And I thought, yeah, probably it's not that easy. And it does. I mean, if this cable, I mean, you can hear it right there. That can be a problem if you're moving your mic during a live stream. I'll be honest, I'm not crazy about the look of it right here. It could be this mic. A lot of times you may see mics where they're in shock mounts and things like that look a little different. This one looks kind of odd. I don't think it's made for this mic, and I'm going to tell you why. I think it's made more for their Elgato USB, which weighs about nothing. But this is a heavy mic. I'm having to crank. There's a little nut here. I'm having to crank, and this is a technical term, the snot out of it, to get it to hold. Now, because I do that, I can't adjust it up and down without doing that. I can swing it.
Mm.
I can swing it right to left. I can tuck it under. And that is a concern for me, because if I don't just really crank it tight, then I run the risk of the arm going down while I'm recording, and that would be bad. The other thing is I had to modify the thread on here with another little adapter to even get the mic to fit. Didn't like that at all. Thankfully, I've got all these pieces and parts that I keep, and that helped. Overall, is it a go or a no-go? And the winner is? Well, for me, it's still the Rode PSA One boom arm. I just think it's a better arm. It stays in place. It works great with my mic, even though you can use any mic with this. And it's under $100. But I tell you what, I'm gonna put a link to both boom arms down in the description. Check them out, look at the budgets, see what works for you. But again, for my money, this is it. Now, I will make this recommendation though, something to think about. You might not wanna go too cheap on a boom arm, especially if you've got a really nice mic, because it can get creaky, it doesn't stay in place. So just think about that. You don't always have to buy the best thing out there, but for a boom arm, you might want to spend a little bit more money. So if this video helps you kind of decide between the boom arms, consider subscribing and liking the video too. Now, if you want to see what I think is the best audio setup for mic and audio interface, check out the video on the screen. I'm Kevin Colby. I'll see you next time.